إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم immigrated to Medina from Mecca. The first thing he did that he built house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Masjid al-Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم. This shows the importance of the Masjid in Islam and in our lives. This shows Muslim relationship and connection with the masjid. Building the house of Allah, building a masjid, there are two types of building the masjid. Imaratun hissiyah, building the masjid in ways that are tangible. Like building the masjid, working for the masjid, cleaning, tidying the masjid, giving the charity to the masjid, all this building the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is great action. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Man bana lillahi masjidan," whoever built house of Allah, "Bana Allahu lahu baytan fil jannah," Allah will build house for him in Jannah. Aisha radiallahu anha said, "Amarana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bi bina'i al-masajid." Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded us to build masajid, house of Allah, wa an tunadhafa wa tutayyib, and it has to be clean and perfumed. Everyone should contribute to build masjid by working for it and giving charity to it, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to do. Also, it is sadaqah jariyah, ongoing sadaqah for you until Yawm al-Qiyamah. So everyone should think about to build house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to give charity to houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu, and this is Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as he said, إِذَا مَاتَ ابْنُ آدَمْ, when son of Adam died, إِنْقَطَ عَمَلُهُ, his good deeds will stop except ثَلَاثَ, إِلَّا مِنْ ثَلَاثَ. And he said, صَدَقَةٌ جَارِيَةٌ, continuous صَدَقَةٌ, ongoing صَدَقَةٌ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you reward until يوم القيامة, inshaAllah ta'ala. The second type of building the house of Allah, عِمَارَةٌ مَعْنَوِيَّةٌ, building the masjid in ways that are intangible, which is pray, establish the prayer, five prayers, salawat in the masajid. Doing adhkar, making dua in the masajid. Reading Quran and studying Quran and seeking knowledge in the masajid. Coming to the lectures and lesson in the masajid. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about this in Surah An-Nur, fi buyutin, in his houses, أَذِنَ اللَّهُ أَن تُرْفَعْ وَيُذْكَرَ فِيهَا اسْمُهُ. In his houses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded to raise his name and remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by seeking knowledge, by adhkar, by dua, by qira'atul Qur'an, by studying Qur'an. يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ فِيهَا بِالْغُدُوِّ وَالْآصَالِ رِجَالِ. Some men there, Allah exalt Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night. رِجَالٌ لَا تُلِهِيهِمْ تِجَارَةٌ وَلَا بَيْعٌ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Their men, their works and their businesses doesn't distract them from coming to masjid and praying and remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِقَامِ الصَّلَاةِ, and establish the prayer in the masjid. And these people will establish the masjid. These people will build the masjid. And this is the purpose of building the masjid. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, seven, يُظِلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظِلِّهِ. Allah will shade them from His shade. يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلُّهُ. Allah will shade them from His shade on يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. There would no shade except His shade. رَجُلٌ, one of them, a man, قَلْبُهُ مُعَلَّقٌ بِالْمَسَاجِدِ. A man whose heart is attached to the masjid. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't say he's staying in the masjid always, 24 hours. But Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said his heart attached to the masjid. Which means whenever, always he's thinking to come to masjid to pray. Like Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to tell Bilal radiallahu anhu, أَرِحْنَا بِهَا يَا Bilal, and he used to give adhan. And he used to tell him, when are you going to give adhan so I can pray and I feel relaxed and I feel happiness when I come to salah and come to masjid? Also, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, وَشَابٌ, a youth, نَشَأَ فِي عِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ, a youth who grew up with worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can be outside of the masjid. You have to come to masjid, then you can worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by prayers, by qira'atul Qur'an, by studying Qur'an, by learning, seeking knowledge. And this has to be from the masjid. And everyone should tell their children to come to masjid from young age. So they will get used to, when they grow up, they will come to masjid regularly. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُ الرَّجُلَ يَعْتَادَ الْمَسْجِدِ. When you see a man come to masjid regularly, فَاشْهَدُوا لَهُ بِالْإِيمَانِ, so testify to his iman. He's mu'min, he's from believers. Some people build the masjid in a different way, like disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned them in Surah At-Tawbah. قال الله تعالى ما كان للمشركين. المشركين, whoever worshiping other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, calling other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, asking other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ما كان للمشركين أن يعمروا مساجد الله شاهدين على أنفسهم بالكفر. They're staying on shirk, they're doing shirk, they're calling Jilani, they're calling other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they're calling Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for help. They can't establish the masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَا كَانَ لِلْمُشْرِكِينَ أَنْ يَعْمُرُوا مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ شَاهِدِينَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ بِالْكُفْرِ أُولَٰئِكَ حَبِطَتْ أَعْمَالُهُمْ. Allah will destroy their deeds. وَفِي النَّارِ هُمْ خَالِدُونَ. And in يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, in Jahannam, they will stay forever. Also we have to establish the masjid by following of sunnah of Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَنْ يُطِعَ الرَّسُولُ Whoever followed Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the messenger, whoever obeyed Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَقَدَ أَطَاعَ اللَّهُ He obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He followed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's command. Establishing the masjid has to be with sunnah of Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't accept from who builds the masjid to do bid'ah innovation. Like Milad, Shabi Barak, making dua together after every single salah and doing politics in the masjid or any other innovation and bid'ah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Man amil amalan, whoever does something, whoever does good deeds, من عمل عملا ليس عليه امرنا نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم didn't command it. نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم didn't command to do ميلاد. نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم didn't command to do شب براد. نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم didn't command to do دعاء after every single salah or anything. نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم didn't do it. صحابة رضي الله عنهم didn't do it. فهو رد. Allah will not accept it. Allah won't accept this bid'ah and innovation. So who can establish the masjid? Who can build the masjid? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah At-Tawbah, إِنَّمَا يَعْمُرُ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ These people, they will establish the masjid, they will build the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who? مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ Who believed in Allah. Believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Believed in Allah has to be believed in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Following the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sunnah, man amana billah. And how can you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and follow the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sunnah? Without knowledge. Without knowledge about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Without knowledge about kalam Allah, speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Without knowledge of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his sunnah. So, we have to seek knowledge about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you can't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a proper way, and you can't believe to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and follow his sunnah. إِنَّمَا يَعْمُرُ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَأَقَامَ الصَّلَاةِ And believe in last day and establish five prayers in the masajid. وَأَقَامَ الصَّلَاةِ They can establish the masjid. So coming to Jum'ah in the masajid, they can't establish the masjid. Coming to one salah or salat al-eid, you can't establish the masjid. Establishing the masajid, building the masajid, has to be when you come to salah, five prayers. When you have mu'allaq, qalbuhu mu'allaqun bil masajid, your heart is attached to the masjid. Your heart is attached to the masjid. Mu'allaqun bil masajid, wa aqama salah, wa ata zakah, and gave charity. وَلَمْ يَخْشَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ And didn't fear anything other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Didn't fear anything except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَعَسَىٰ أُولَٰئِكَ أَن يَكُونُوا مِنَ الْمُهْتَدِينَ They will be a guided. They will be muhtadeen amongst muhtadeen. Allah will guide them in right way, right path. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Kuffar Quraysh, They used to build house of Allah in Mecca, Masjid al-Haram. They used to build Kaaba, the best place. They used to serve people and hujjaj, feed them, give them water to drink. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَجَعَلْتُمْ And they used to think we worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by this. But this is not real, just you building the masajid, serve people in the masjid. But you're in shirk, in bid'ah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said next ayah, أَجَعَلْتُمْ سِقَايَةَ الْحَاجِ Did you make feeding people and give them water to drink to hujjaj? وَعِمَارَةَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ And building the masjid al-haram al-ka'ba. كَمَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ Who believed in Allah? Who believed in the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Who followed Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam like companions of Sahaba radiallahu anhum. كَمَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ They believed in
last day, يوم الآخر. وجاهد في سبيل الله, and they did jihad in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's way. لا يستوون عند الله. They're not equal in the sight of Allah. They're not same in the sight of Allah. So you have to build a masajid. You have to build a masajid and give the charity to the masajid. Also, you have to come to pray. And this is the second type of building the masajid. Come to pray all the time. You have attachment to the masjid, and you have your family has attachment to the masjid. Then you can protect yourself from amongst disbelievers, from Ahlul Bidah, from Ahlul Ma'asi who do sins. You can protect yourself by this. لا يستوون عند الله. So when you come to masjid, you have attachment to the masjid, you come regularly to the masjid, you seek knowledge from the masjid, your children seek knowledge from the masjid, then you build house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in proper way. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا مَاتَ بِآدَمَ انْقَطَعَ عَمَلُهُ. When son of Adam passed away, died, انْقَطَعَ عَمَلُهُ, his good deeds will stop. No good deeds when you passed away, when you died. Except three, إِلَّا مِنْ ثَلَاثَ. And I said, صَدَقَةٌ جَارِيَةٌ. Continuous sadaqah, ongoing sadaqah, like you give to masajid or places for seeking knowledge, madrasa. And then he said, and this is the building the first time. Second time, عِلْمٌ يُنْتَفَعُ بِهِ. Knowledge, people gain benefit from that knowledge. People gain benefit from that knowledge. You give charity to them and you seek knowledge from them. This is continuum for you. This is amal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if he passed away, Allah will reward you until yawm al-qiyamah. Last, awwaladun salihun yad'u lahu. A good child, salih child, make dua for you. Make dua for you. And how can you make good child and you don't put him to madaris, you don't put him to masjid, you don't tell him to come to masjid regularly, you don't put him to the classes in the masjid. أَوَّلَدٍ صَالِحٍ يَدْعُو لَهُ. When he died, well, this son who learned, who studied, that he will make dua for you. أَوَّلَدٍ صَالِحٍ يَدْعُو لَهُ. بَارَكَ اللَّهُ لِي وَلَكُمْ فِي الْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ ونفعنا وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله على فضله وإنعامه, والشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله, صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه. أما بعد, so many people gave charity to the masajid. So many people gave charity to the masajid for sake of Allah or any places. But they want also benefit from dunya. They want also benefit from people. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about in Surah Al-Baqarah, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, all you who have believed, O believers, لَا تُبْطِلُوا صَدَقَاتِكُمْ. Don't destroy your sadaqats. Don't destroy your sadaqats. How? بِالْمَنِّ وَالْأَذَى. By reminding, by hurting people, I spent like that, I gave to you this amount. لَا تُبْطِلُوا صَدَقَاتِكُمْ. You will destroy your sadaqats, your charity. Because you should have sincerity, ikhlas for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He gave charity to the masjid for sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not for people. لا نريد منكم جزاء ولا شكورا. We don't want
from you reward and no thank.
You don't want to, don't thank me.
I want to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I gave you charity. I have opportunity to get my to get reward in the dunya. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Those who spend their wealth in the way of Allah. ثُمَّ لَا يَتْبِعُونَ مَا أَنْفَقُوا مَنًّا وَلَا أَذَى. And then don't follow up what they have spent with reminders of it. And hurting people, telling people what they did, what they spent and how much spent. Because they don't want benefit from people. They don't want people praise them. But they want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What they're going to get? لَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. They will get reward in their Lord. Allah will reward you in dunya and akhirah. If you have the ikhlas and sincerity. Ibad Allah, my brothers, or servants of Allah. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to Medina, لما قدم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم المدينة وجد اليهود يصومون عاشوراء. He found اليهود fasting on 10th of Muharram. فقال ما هذا اليوم الذي تصومون فيه. What this day you are fasting? Why do you fast on 10th of Muharram? They said, فقال هذا يوم عظيم. This is a great day. نَجَّلَّهُ فِيهِ مُوسَى وَقَوْمَهُ. Allah saved Musa and his people. وَأَغْرَقَ فِرْعَوْنَ وَقَوْمَهُ. And Allah destroyed Fir'aun and his people. فَصَامَهُ مُوسَى شُكْرًا لِلَّهِ. Musa alayhi salam fasted, thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He saved him from Fir'aun. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, نَحْنُ أَحَقُّ بِمُوسَى مِنْكُمْ. We are closer to Musa than you. We follow Musa alayhi salam's religion, which is Islam. You don't follow the religion of Musa alayhi salam. نَحْنُ أَحَقُّ بِمُوسَى مِنْكُمْ. We are closer to Musa alayhi salam. فَصَامَهُ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم fasted on 10th of Muharram. وَأَمَرَ بِصِيَامِهِ. And he commanded to fast on 10th of Muharram. And النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إِنِّي أَحْتَسِبُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. I hope Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أَن يُكَفِّرَ السَّنَةَ الَّتِي قَبْلَهِ. Allah will forgive your past year sins if you fast on 10th of Muharram. Sahaba radiallahu anhum asked Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we can't follow Yahud and Nasara. We can't follow disbelievers. They fast in one day and we fast the same day. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَإِذَا كَانَ الْعَامُ الْمُقْبِلِ إِنْشَاءَاللَّهُ صُمْنَا الْيَوْمَ التَّاسِعِ. The next year inshaAllah ta'ala will fast on 9th of Muharram. So we fast 2 days instead of one day. One day, we don't follow Yahud and Nasara 9th of Muharram, and the second, Ashura, to follow Musa alayhi salam. فَلَمْ يَأْتِ الْعَامُ الْمُقْبِلِ. And the next year, حَتَّى تُوَفِّيَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away next year. So my brothers and sisters in Islam, make sure you fast on 9th of Muharram and 10th of Muharram, which is Wednesday and Thursday. أَلَا وَصَلُّوا وَسَلِّمُوا عَلَى مَنْ أَمْرَكُمُ اللَّهُ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالسَّلَامِ عَلَيْهِ. فَقَالَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. اللهم صل وسلم على عبدك ورسولك محمد. وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر الصحابة أجمعين وعنا معهم بعفوك وكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين وانصر عبادك الموحدين. اللهم انصر عبادك الموحدين. اللهم فرج هم المهمومين. اللهم فرج هم المهمومين ونفس كرب المكروبين واقض الدين عن المدينين واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم بارك لمن ساهم في بناء هذا المسجد. اللهم بارك لمن ساهم في بناء هذا المسجد والعاملين عليها، اللهم اجزهم خير الجزاء، اللهم اجزهم خير الجزاء، اللهم اجعل هذا المسجد منارة للعلم والمعرفة، منارة للعلم والمعرفة ونشر سنة نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم يا رب العالمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله، اذكروا الله العظيم الجليل يذكركم، واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم، ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون.